Welcome to another session of wireless communication and networks. Unit 2, mobile data propagation, large scale path loss. After the completion of the three basic propagation mechanisms, reflection, diffraction, and scattering, now we are going for calculation of path loss by using practical manner. That is, we are going for theoretical part. This is how to calculate reflection losses, diffraction losses, scattering losses. Now we are moved to the practical session. That is practical link budget design. Practical link budget design using path loss models. Using path loss models. Here, suppose you are going for right, but in this laboratory, first we are calculating theoretical values. How much output voltage we are getting, how much output current we are calculating. Just you are comparing this in practical sessions. After practical session, just compare the theoretical and practical one. Similarly, this practical link budget calculation, practical link budget calculation, so depends upon the same thing. Nothing but here, radio propagation models. Radio propagation models are derived from analytical and empirical methods. Analytical and empirical methods. Here, what is meant by analytical method and what is meant by empirical method? Here, the empirical method is nothing but based upon the drawing of curves in a graph. We have to check what is the exact propagation, what is the transmitted power, what is the received power, and how much loss we are getting. But in analytical method, we have to recreate a set of measured data. Based upon the data, we have to check. That is the difference between empirical method and analytical method. Here, what is the use of these methods? Here, the using of these methods, or we have to consider the propagation factors, both known and unknown factors in the actual field. Here, in this practical link budget method, we have to calculate a path loss. How much loss we are getting? That is, what is the difference between transmitted power and received power within a function of distance? Suppose the mobile unit which is nearer to the base station, nothing but we are getting high signal strength normal. Suppose the distance is increases, the signal strength also decreases. Suppose you take your mobile and go nearer to the base station, we are getting high signal strength lines. It shows in your mobile. Suppose you are moving to 15 kilometers, what about the signal strength? It shows in your mobile, automatically that decreases. Whenever the distance is increases between transmitter to receiver, automatically the signal strength can be decreases. Right. Here, for this calculation of practical link budget using path loss model, the first model we have to take is log distance path loss model. Log distance path loss model. Here, in both theoretical and practical propagation model, which indicates the average received signal power increases logarithmically with a distance, whether it is an indoor or outdoor. Whenever the distance between transmitter receiver increases, automatically the received power also decreases. Now we have to calculate the average large scale path loss with respect to t. What is meant by small d here? Small d is nothing but the distance between to transmit to receiver. D naught is nothing but whenever the mobile unit move nearer to the base station, that is receiver nearer to the transmitter, at that time the distance is d naught. And small n is path loss exponent. Then the average large scale path loss, PL of T, PL of bar of T, here bar shows average, is proportional to d by d naught of power of n or pl of bar of in terms of dv, which is equal to pl of bar of d naught plus 10n log of d by d naught. Here what is meant by n? Path loss exponent. Here say this one in this table, table 2 shows what the path loss exponent for different environment. Suppose free space, the path loss exponent is 2. For urban area cellular radio, it is 2.7 to 3.5. Shadowed urban cellular radio, 3 to 5. In building line of sight, 1.6 to 1.8. Obstructed in building, 4 to 6. Obstructed in factories, 2 to 3. This is a different environment with respect to the path loss exponent. Path loss exponent. In general, the distance between the transmitter that take a reference distance is 1 kilometer. That is, suppose I had to assume that in this equation, right? D is equal to D equal to 1 kilometer. What is the D naught? Motion should be less than 1 kilometer. Suppose I had to assume that 100 meters to 1 meter. This is a simple formula. We have to calculate the what is the how much loss between transmitter power to receiver power with respect to distance. With respect to distance. Here in this equation shows only loss with respect to surroundings considered. That is the drawback of this model. That's why we are moved to the next one is log normal shadowing. Log normal shadowing. Here in this log normal shadowing, we have to consider the surroundings between transmitter to receiver. In previous section, we have to consider only the distance, but here we have to calculate the surroundings also to measure how much loss we are getting. Then this model specifies exactly where is the exact location of transmitter receiver and what is the surroundings. Is there any hill stations or valley points or buildings or trees? Is there? We also have to consider. That's why this equation show here PL of D dB, which is equal to PL of bar of D plus X sigma, which is equal to PL bar of D naught plus 10n log of d by d naught plus x sigma. Here that is the difference between previous 68 equation and 69 equation. Here 68 equation there is no x sigma, but here we are getting x sigma. Here what is my x sigma? Is nothing but Gaussian distributed random variable. Zero mean of Gaussian distributed random variable. Here in general, what is meant by Gaussian noise? Gaussian noise is nothing but in that particular signal having noise. Just you have to predict whether noise is present or no. We don't know, but we have to assume in that signal having noise. That is prediction. That is a Gaussian noise. We have to add it here. Then relation here. See this one relation. What is meant by PR of D, which is equal to PT of DB. I mean PT of D minus PL of D. That is, otherwise you get the PL of D, which is equal to P transmitter minus P receiver. Nothing but here in this log normal model, we have to consider shadowing effect. Okay, what is going to be shadowing effect? The shadowing effect, nothing but we have to consider the surroundings of the transmitter to receiver, not only distance. That's why it is called a log normal shadowing. That's why we have to consider Gaussian noise here. Just we have to add to Gaussian noise to normal path loss model. It is called as a log normal shadowing, which is also in terms of dB is the units. dB is the units. Here, for this purpose, number of algorithms or simulation tools are available to calculate this loss, path loss models. And this is depends upon D value, D naught value, N value, and surroundings and standard deviation. Right. Here, before going to the Q function, here see this one. This figure shows the x-axis is a TR separation, that is transmitter receiver separation in terms of kilometer path loss. Whenever the separation is increased, suppose this is a 0.1 kilometer. This is 1 kilometer. This is 10 kilometer. See this one from 0.1 to 10 kilometer path loss increases. Then whenever the distance is increased, path loss can be increases. That is the relation between path loss and distance. Here, you know the what is meant by Q function. What is meant by Q function in communication? I think this Q function here coming in the digital communication. That is a thing where we had to calculate how much error is present between transmitter signal and received signal. We are going for error function. Error function also called as the Q function. Here the Q function is calculated. Here the Q of Z, which that is general equation is Q of Z, which is equal to 1/√2π integral of Z to infinity exponential of minus x square by 2 dx. Otherwise, G is equal to, after simplification, 1/2 brackets starts 1 minus error function of Z by root 2. Where Q of Z is equal to 1 minus Q of minus Z. This is about general function of error function, which is used to calculate how much error we are getting from transmitter to receiver. Similarly, the probability that the received signal level will exceed certain value can be calculated from the cumulative density function as the received power is the received power with respect to distance is greater than gamma. Here gamma is threshold function, which is equal to Q of gamma minus PR of D bar divided by sigma. See this one. Suppose the received signal is below the gamma value, then which is a Q function is Q of PR of D bar minus gamma by sigma. That is, we have to check the threshold value. Okay, what is meant by threshold value in general? Suppose the threshold value we have to fix, above the threshold value, the signal strength is high. Below the threshold value, the signal strength is low. Here, this equations based upon this gamma value, whether it is above or below. Right. Till now we are discussing about how to calculate the loss, path loss for general case with respect to distance. For large shadowing cases, we have to consider both surroundings also. Now we have to calculate the determination of percentage of coverage area. Determination of percentage of coverage area. Suppose we have to fix one base station. The particular base station, how much distance it covers. How much distance it covers. It is called the determination of percentage of coverage area. Right. Suppose for this purpose, how much it covers is depends upon the received signal threshold. That is, the threshold value is gamma. Threshold value is gamma. Right. Suppose we have to fix the type of antenna at the base station is omnidirectional antenna system. Here, what is meant by omnidirectional antenna system? Omnidirectional antenna system is nothing but which radiates power equally in all directions. Equally in all directions. Suppose that's why we have to draw a circle from the base station. The coverage radius is capital R, and threshold value is gamma. Then the percentage of coverage area is capital U of gamma, right? Here, suppose you have to assume that small d, small is meant by d, the distance between base station to mobile station or transmitter to receiver. Whenever now I am assuming d equal to small r, just I am assuming for simplification d equal to small r, then the percentage of coverage area with respect to incremental area is dA, then u of gamma, which is equal to 1 by pi r square integral of PR of r greater than gamma dA, which is equal to 1 by pi capital R square integral 0 to 2 pi integral 0 to r PR of r greater than gamma r dr into d theta. That is, we have to take the incremental area dA. It depends upon how much distance between the transmitter receiver and how much angle it arrives. That's why it is r into dr into d theta. For simplification of this, PR of r greater than gamma, by using this Q function, see this equation, Q of gamma of PR of r bar by sigma, which is equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 error function of gamma minus PR of r bar divided by sigma root 2. Just substitute. What is meant PR of r? What is meant PR of r in general equation? PT minus PL of bar of D naught plus 10 n log r by D naught. Actually, in previous session, instead of small r, we are using small d. But we are assuming that for simplification, d equal to r. That's why using this r here divided by sigma root 2. After this one, now what is the path loss? To simplify the above equation, if you remember 74, first of all, we are check the path loss, PLR bar of r, which is equal to 10 n log capital R by r d naught plus 10 n log of r by capital R plus PL bar of d naught. Just see, substitute this equation, previous one. Right, now we are getting PR value. Let, we had, see, for simplification purpose, let alpha equal to gamma minus PT plus PL bar of D naught plus 10 n log R capital R by D naught divided by sigma root 2. Similarly, B equal to 10 n log of E by sigma root 2. Then automatically U of gamma, which is equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by R capital R square integral 0 to R of error function of A plus B ln of small r by capital R dr. Right. Here substitute t equal to a plus b log r capital small r by capital R, then the percentage of coverage area u of gamma, which is equal to 1 minus error function of a plus exponential of 1 minus 2ab by b square bracket against that 1 minus error function of 1 minus ab by b. All equations, suppose you have to assume that a equal to 0. A equal to 0. Why we suppose when we are assuming a equal to 0, the received power with the radius of r, which is equal to threshold value, nothing but the signal strength maximum almost at that time, a equal to 0. Then coverage u of r, which is equal to 1 by 2. Bracket start 1 plus exponential of 1 by b square. Again, bracket start 1 minus error function of 1 by b. Here, this percentage of coverage here is also depends upon the path loss exponent value and sigma value. Let's see this one. The figure shows C sigma by L. And y-axis is a fraction of total area with signal above the threshold. Signal above the threshold. Nothing but signal above the threshold means good signal strength. Good signal strength. But here, see this one. Whenever the sigma by n is increases, the signal strength above threshold decreases. It depends upon the path loss exponent. That is, the path loss exponent is different from free space to shadow case, urban area, rural area, forest. The path loss exponent can be changed. That's why somewhat decreases here. That is, Yes, n equal to 2, that is free space. We are getting sigma equal to 8 dB. 75% boundary coverage, which provide 91% free space. But we are going for urban area. For urban area, n equal to 3. The max of 50% of boundary coverage, 70% area coverage. 70% area coverage. But among the 70%, only 50% finally we are getting. Right. This is about the practical link budget using path loss models. Here in this practical budget models, here we are calculating path loss, general path loss equation, log shadowing path loss equation, and how much percentage of coverage area can be calculated in this practical link budget. Do you have any query? Type your query in a chat box. Thank you very much for attending today's session.